Oscar-winning film drama, they shoot horses, don't they, in 40 minutes. The Battle for the Ashes is hotting up before that on BBC One, with highlights from the first day and the third test with Richie Beno.
Day of the third test match at Old Trafford, and Michael Atherton is very much in the driving seat. He's on his home ground, he's now England's longest serving test match captain, and best of all, from his point of view anyway, his team is still one up in this Ashes series. Atherton's local knowledge could be a key factor in this match. With so little between the teams and so much at stake, his close acquaintance with weather conditions and the likely performance of the Old Trafford pitch could prove quite decisive. 4 years ago, the Australians won this test with the help of some wizardry from Shane Warne. This time, though, on what's likely to be a slow pitch with some variable bounce, they could be looking to their quicker bowlers to make an impact. Not least Glenn McGrath, their hero from Lords, and Jason Gillespie, who returns to the side after injury and who had a seven-wicket haul in the Australians' tour match defeat of Hampshire down at Southampton. Welcome to the highlights of the opening day of this third test match, the Cornhill test match at Old Trafford. And the weather, once again, is going to play a key part. First of all, we have the England side not named till the morning of the match. That's the final 11. And Simon Hughes now is with the two skippers. He can give us the lineup of these two teams.
Mark, you've won the toss. Are you happy about that?
I'm always happy about winning the toss. I think there'll be a bit in the wicket. There's has been in the first two, but it looks a bit bare at both ends, so hopefully it'll turn towards the end of the game.
So you're going to bat first?
We're going to bat first, yeah.
And you've got your fastest bowler, Jason Gillespie, back?
Yeah, it's nice to have him back from injuries. The games he's played in so far for Australia has been quite a strike force for us, so it's nice to have him back.
There's a sign of a riding tide of optimism in the rising tide of optimism in the Australian camp.
Yeah, we've started to play better cricket. We had a good win against Hampshire during the week. We're very much looking forward to the next 5 days.
But you're a set down, so to speak. You've got a break back.
That's exactly right, and that's what we're here for over the next 5 days. And but as I said to the guys, we're only one nil away from one test match away from being in front of the series. So we're not that disappointed at this stage, but we've got some work to do.
Good luck.
Thanks, Mike.
Mike, third time unlucky. Probably not a bad toss to lose.
Yeah, I think there'll be a bit in the wicket. It's fairly damp in the middle of the wicket, but as Mark said, it's bare at the end, so might be a bit of turn later in the match.
And what's your team news?
We've got Dean Headley for Devon Malcolm.
What's the reason for that?
Well, I think that the pitch is going to favour seam bowling for the early part of it with the dampness there. Dean Headley's that kind of bowler, straight, hits the seam, gets it in the right areas for the majority of the time. So I think that might favour, the conditions might favour him here.
There's a mini resurgence in British sport. How's that affecting morale?
Well, we started off in a way with Texaco wins in the first test. Obviously tennis and the Lions have got it going as well. It'd be nice for us to continue the trend here.
And I guess it's nice also to be back at a ground where you can expect some proper vocal support.
Yeah, I'd like to think that the crowd here at Old Trafford will get right behind our boys and give them a big rap.
Best of luck.
Thanks very much.
Simon Hughes with the two skippers there. And just confirmation of those words from Mark Taylor and Michael Atherton. The England side, Atherton himself, Butcher, Stewart, Hussain, Thorpe, Crawley, Elam, Croft, Gough, Caddick and Dean Headley at the bottom of the list. And the Australians, Taylor, Elliott, Blewett, the two Wars, Bevan, Healy, Warne, Rifle, Gillespie and McGrath. The umpires for this game, George Sharp and Venkat, the former Indian spinner, Venkat Raghavan, and the third umpire, John Hampshire. Ranjan Madigalla is the match referee. The Australians won the toss and confirmation that they will bat. Well, there's certainly been plenty of rain in the lead up to this test match. And let's join Geoffrey Boycott now out in the centre to find out what sort of a strip Peter Maron, the groundsman, has provided.
With all the rain about recently, this pitch has caused a little bit of a problem for the captains. you look at it, it's not a good looking pitch. Patchy, grassy areas, but to be fair to Old Trafford, it's never looked a good looking pitch, and it's usually played better than it looks. What's worrying everybody are all these grassy areas here. You see these patchy bits of green grass, fresh green grass. When the ball hits these, it's bound to seam. There's no way it can't. When it hits the dry areas or the non-grassy areas, then it'll go through probably on a lowish bounce, all the rain seeped underneath, and what it does, it takes the sting out of the pitch, takes the pace out of it, should be a medium to slow seaming pitch. But I think for the captains, the dodgy part is they know early on there's going to be movement for the seamers. Most seamers would like a bowl on this sort of stuff, get one or two early wickets, but for the captains, they have to decide this is a five-day test match, two innings each. And what they're worried about is that these dry areas here will come into play over 5 days for the spinners. And you've got to remember it's a five-day test match. So all in all, a ticklish decision that Taylor's had to make.
Geoffrey Boycott with his ideas on the many problems the batsmen will face in the opening session of this game. We join the action now in the first over. Darren Goff is the bowler. He's bowling from the Stretford end. Mark Taylor is taking strike and no runs are on the board.
That's a useful delivery. That's the line, the ideal line to bowl for left-handers. And that would test anyone. An awkward delivery for Mark Taylor early on. And he's the man who's made the decision to bat this morning. That's off the edge and dropping just a couple of feet short of Mark Butcher. That's what Darren Goff's aiming for. It's that area there outside off stump where Mark Taylor is going to feel that he's going to have to play at some of those. Well, Dean Headley, brisk medium pace, but with a bouncer here that was dead on target, certainly straight, and Mark Taylor just took his eyes off the ball a little bit. Classic error. I think that took him by surprise a bit. That's well bowled. That's the right line. And if Darren Goff hits the seam on a regular basis, well, the ball is definitely going to move this morning. It's surely enough given this pitch to help the ball move off the seam. That's beautifully bowled. That's absolutely ideal.
You always get to some deliveries that zip off the bits of green grass. And so it's going to be hard work for the batsman. They're going to have to graft and work.
Very awkward delivery from Darren Goff.
Well, I think when Mark Taylor took the decision to bat this morning, I think he knew it wasn't easy, and it will be a struggle.
Inside edge, that's going to go down very fine for four runs. Matthew Elliott will be grateful enough, but won't really know how he did that.
Be a hunt the ball, and you're going to need quite a lot of luck to survive, as well as quite a bit of skill.
A rather more confident shot this time from Matthew Elliott, pushed away for three. Test match cricket. Mark Taylor is the man out. Australia 9 for 1. That was a nice piece of bowling by Dean Headley. He's been persistent there on that line roundabout off stump. We've seen the ball seaming around.
footwork is not very good by Mark Taylor. I know he's made a couple of hundreds, one in the test match against Hampshire, but even so, he's still got a lot of work to do for me.
So Dean Headley has his first wicket in test match cricket. Greg Blewett is the new batsman. Sliced away by Matthew Elliott. Chase now for Robert Croft. The outfield slowish. Slow enough to allow Croft to catch the ball just a yard or two inside the boundary. Good firm shot, right off the meat of the bat. And just enough power to overcome the outfield. Anything right up there is put away normally very powerfully. That was more timed than hit. I know it's been wet here, but as yet no evidence we're going to need the lifeguards. Certainly not at the back of the stands, anyway.
Laid on. Dragged it back on. There's not much pace in the pitch, and the bounce seems to be slow. Batsmen need to be careful of square cutting in conditions like this, and Blewett has dragged it back on to his stumps.
The dreaded death rattle. It's the last sound a batsman wants to hear. Even when it's only a little clunk, it's not very pleasant.
Mark Waugh, fresh from 100 against Hampshire down in Southampton. 22 for 2. That's well bowled.
Bowled a very impressive line, particularly to the left-handers, Dean Headley. Once again, that movement off the seam.
And that one's drawn him into the stroke this time rather than a defensive push. There's just enough movement there for both Gough and Headley, but it is the sort of thing you'd expect first morning of a test match. It's a good one, that's the leg cutter. So there's a little bit there going both ways for Headley. He's been quite impressive.
Ball getting through Mark Waugh. Just not sure whether there mightn't have been an inside edge there. No, looks like it got through and actually hit the pad.
Scream of anguish you heard there came from Headley, and that's why, over the top of middle and off.
And that hops up, and that comes from nowhere. Now Andy Carter gets some lift, but that really climbed. Oh, that was in the air and just wide of third slip. Nasser Hussain was the man who dived to his right, and he's a great sense of anticipation, fine pair of hands, but just that little bit too wide.
Oh, that's a bad ball. That's a shocker. Well, you've just bowled a good ball and a little bit of a streaky shot, and then you give him a shocker like that.
Well, he got his run-up wrong, didn't he? So seemed to be sprinting in, and he's not going to be a fearful sight to anybody, certainly of Mark Waugh's calibre, and then pulled it down. Could have hit that anywhere on the offside. Oh, well bowled, and that's out. Well, well, two fours and a thank you very much. exactly what Mark Elam has been trying to do, I hope. Line length. And he gets that ball to run away. A little bit in the air, a little bit further off the pitch. And Alex Stewart takes a good catch. Now then, this is Steve Waugh, another of the world's outstanding batsmen. But certainly when three wickets go down, there's a little coughing and spluttering in any dressing room. And Australia's will be no different. Oh, well bowled again. Well, what an extraordinary over. We've seen the ball race away to the third man boundary three times now. Steve Waugh's off the mark now with the three. Oh, well bowled. And that's four more runs. You see, it's worth playing without the third man, but one swings in, one goes straight on, find the edge of the bat. But the runs have been flooding. 15 in that over. And 15 for the cost of one wicket. Very difficult decisions out there for Michael Atherton. Well, well, do you know, at Lord's when Steve Waugh was out first ball, he plays straight across it towards mid-wicket. And if only that had been a straight ball, he might just have done the same. Oh, well bowled again. And again, an odd sequence of footwork, I must say. It just sort of went for a stroll.
Well, he plays back all the time, but he shouldn't have played at this. Look how wide it is. I mean, that's a long, long way wide, isn't it?
Well, he squeezed that one away. Very strong area, traditionally, for left-handers, square on the offside. Although this outfield is quite slow today, that had enough guts in it to reach the boundary. That's through that gap between the slips and the gully. And four more runs. Well worth asking. Didn't move away as so many of his deliveries have done.
Yes, it was certainly well worth asking the question. See, it's hitting very high on the flap of the pad. Pretty hard to give that out.
Beautifully bowled. Well, play that if you can. Matthew Elliott has survived it.
Yes, as a batsman, I don't think you worry too much about these. When they go quickly, they go a long way, and they bounce as well, you usually feel that you're never, ever going to nick one of those.
And it's awkward when the trap is set. Matthew Elliott decided at Lord's when the trap was set to try and leave the ball alone and get out the way. Here he takes a blow. Another short delivery. So this morning, the honours shared. 74 for three. One ball is left of this morning session. And runs coming from it. That's nicely clipped away. Beautifully timed, actually, by Steve Waugh. So Australia finish on a high note.
Six from 91 balls, and he is in form. And he's got away with that. He played and missed it quite a number before lunch, but probably no more so than you do in a normal fiery first session of a test match. Well run. They ran that second one very, very quickly, just sensing that the ball was getting away from the fieldsman, Michael Atherton. He shouts there, and Elliott is far from happy, but it's immaterial. He still has to go. It started off as a moderate appeal and finally became a fully fledged one, and Elliott had to go for 40. Caught by Stuart Orphan.
That one goes off the seam and bounces quite a bit. And Elliott then rubbed his elbow. Maybe we see here with the ball bouncing just a touch. And it's just grazed the elbow there. So that's the reason why Matthew Elliott was a little disappointed.
85 for 4 at the moment. Elliott, quite obviously a little unlucky there. Michael Bevan's new man in. That's a good stroke. The golf won't be too pleased with the actual delivery. Half volley outside leg stump. But Steve Waugh is put away very well.
Beautifully bowled again. Good length, fairly straight, nipping away from him, squared him up. He does get in that very square position, does Michael Bevan.
A very confident appeal from Dean Headley, the bowler. He's bowled a good line. Nothing erratic about him at all. Good line to the left-hander, pitching just on, straightening a bit perhaps, and seeing Michael Bevan not making much ground with the front foot. Good shout. Through the gap, and we've seen quite a few of those today. The ball racing away for 4 runs. Finds a gap. Not sure it came off the middle of the bat. Certainly gone right through for the 3rd run, the 4th run. They've run 4. Well, really, Alex Stewart is moving one way, and the ball, after bouncing, appeared to swing a long way. And that brings the 100 up, 103 for 4. It's quick and nasty. I think Steve Waugh had no trouble at all in spotting it. And then watch that ball swing. Ooh, well fielded, well fielded. Wonderful enthusiasm from Darren Goff. I mean, it's businesslike as well. It's his daily work, but there's a bubble about his play and movement. Here he comes. It's almost as if he's still a kid on the beach.
Not to be denied. Bowled really well. It's his 3rd wicket, his 1st test match. And Michael Bevan goes 113 for 5.
Well, it was a good ball. I suppose any wicket's a good ball, but it's the length, it zips away. And Michael Bevan, I said all along, I don't think he can play at test level getting chest on to deliveries like this. Look how he is with the feet pointing down the pitch. Chest on, he's opened up. I think he's going to struggle all the time.
Ian Healy is the new batsman. 113 for 5. Strader, I must remind you, winning the toss, batting first.
Shot.
That's a fine shot. I think Darren Goff's going well to keep it up to Steve Waugh. But he needs a bit more protection on the drive now. Suddenly the
The ball has been fired off the middle of Steve Waugh's bat. Oh, well bowled. Not out, says George Sharp. Really, says Darren Goff? Yes, says George Sharp. And he'll probably explain to him how the ball's probably nicked the inside edge of the bat, or he was just outside off stump. Outside off stump. Oh, that was quick, and that cut back a little bit outside off stump. It's good aggressive stuff, this.
This is a good pressure over, some very good deliveries here. Haven't got wickets, putting the batsman under pressure.
Good shot. Atherton might have got a thumb to that, but no more. It's a long run for Croft. No speed at all in this outfield today yet. And they've run four.
That was very nearly through.
It almost appeared as if Ian Healy was a little bit late on it. And then it clipped the top of the pad and went through.
For Steve Waugh, and that's a very good innings. 50 from 73 deliveries. That's good scoring when conditions have favoured the bowler. That's a fine shot from Steve Waugh. That's exactly what we mean when we say he's quiet and efficient. No undue flourish about the shot. Weight was in the right place. The bat just firmly met the ball. Absolutely square on. It was always four.
That's what you want, to ball that length. Now that was lucky. It's been disappointing today because his length's been all over the place. Maybe Michael Atherton should have thought of changing ends for him, see if that does the trick.
Not much has seemed, not much has swung just in these last 15, 20 minutes. That's done something. Done too much. That's another good shot. That's a real strength for Steve Waugh on the leg stump. And the boundary, bringing up Australia's 150. We're all asking, he's been given. Andy Caddick breaks his duck for the day. And there's an element of good fortune about it. The ball was aimed down the leg side. Ian Healy just trying to flick it away into the acres of space that there are down on that leg side. Just gets a thin nick through to Alex Stewart.
Alex Stewart got a good look at it. Healy is playing the ball well outside of his body, so the keeper gets a good look. He's well and truly on the move. That's a pretty good catch from Alex Stewart. Very good footwork. He's using the skip method where he brings his feet up together. And he's taken that well. That brings Shane Warne to the crease.
Well, it's a whisker away again. And that was batsman error. No doubt about that this time. Steve Waugh somehow lured into this. His concentration normally is pretty good. But the shot was never on. Oh, great shots. Steve Waugh really launching into that one. It wasn't quite the half volley that it was made to look. Steve Waugh just unleashed the bat through the line of the ball. That should be out and is given. Everyone in the England camp seemed confident enough. Umpire Venkatragovan just took a couple of seconds, I think, to give Shane Warne the chance to get himself away from the crease voluntarily.
Mark Elam proving himself to be a real wicket taker.
So Australia, 160 for 7. That's well timed again. That's been the most productive shot, I think, for Steve Waugh today. Everything up on his toes, he's clipped away with power and timing.
Safe. 4 over the top of the slips and takes the Australians a little closer to that 200 mark now. Well, it was a good effort. It was perfectly timed by Steve Waugh. Nothing difficult about the ball. A full toss on leg stump. To make it worse, not only was it a full toss outside leg stump, but it was also no ball. It looked as though it was a nick from the waving of the arms. No signal from the umpire, so we can say that that did get a rather fine edge. Moved away off the seam from the right-hander. There's the edge, and it keeps going. Looked as though it got to Stewart a bit quicker than he thought. Yeah, I don't think the bowler would be very happy about that. Not that it was a particularly good ball. Full toss on leg stump deserves to go for 4, but not quite under the body of the diving fielder.
Well, that's quite a vicious delivery and probably better than bowling a bouncer to the opposition fast bowler. The bowler's got to hobble up and bowl the next day because of a bruised thigh. You've won a pretty good victory.
Look for 2 again, and that'll bring up the 50 partnership. They're very handy runs. 211 for 7.
He hasn't played and missed much. That was a really good ball that got him playing and missing at it, but he's worked at his batting. Gets right behind the ball and makes your ball to his strengths.
But not so. Very, very good 100. When Steve Waugh looks back in years to come, I doubt if he'll find many better innings he's played than that one. Super knock, 100 out of 223. Yeah! Everyone's running around, and Alex Stewart has claimed the catch. Robert Croft has shown typical enthusiasm. George Sharp has hardly moved a muscle or an eyebrow, and certainly not a finger.
It seemed to bounce a little bit, didn't it? There seemed to be a bit of a nick there, and actually it was a good catch in the end.
Might have been a moment of luck there for the Australians. They finished on 224 for 7, just the same moment as when it looked as though Alex Stewart might have taken that catch. And a very, very fine performance from Steve Waugh. Unbeaten on 102, I think one of the best innings I've ever seen him play. When the Australians started, they would have given anything to make 200. They lost wickets early. Steve Waugh held them together. And there's that splendid partnership at the end with Paul Rifle. 224 for 7. And the bowling figures for England, I was very impressed with Dean Headley today. 23 overs, 4 maidens, 3 for 67. He was very cool, showed no nerves at all in making his Test match debut. And also Mark Elam, I thought they were the two best bowlers. 3 for 67 and 2 for 34. A wicket for Darren Goff. I was surprised he was kept out of the attack for so long. One for Andy Carrick, and Robert Croft bowled only 4 overs, 2 of them just because the light was bad at the end. So a magnificent performance from Steve Waugh, and here he is now talking with Simon Hughes.
Steve, how does that rate in your pantheon of Test hundreds?
I think it's up there. I think it probably is my best Test hundred, particularly the way I started out. I was very scratchy first 10, 20 runs, I guess, and the wicket was very difficult in those conditions, and I hadn't come into the Test with much form, so I really had to dig deep, and I was very happy with the way I played.
You make a habit of playing very well on difficult wickets.
Yes and no. I've had a few failures on difficult wickets, but I do enjoy the challenge. I guess you need a bit of luck, which I proved today early on. I played missed a few times and was a bit shaky, but you've got to remain positive, I guess, and if the ball's up there to hit, you try and put it away, and I think we did that pretty well.
You played the seaming ball very well.
Well, I guess I did. I got runs out there, and it was tough. It was one of the toughest wickets I've played Test cricket on, so I think 220 is a pretty good score.
Indeed, 220 is a big score, and I think the pitch will be in much the same condition for the second day's play as it was today. We've had a very interesting day here today, the opening one of this Cornhill Test match, and here's Ian Chappell now with Geoffrey Boycott with their ideas on it.
Well, for me, Ian, Mark Taylor's ticklish decision worked out reasonably okay in the end, didn't it?
Yes, I think the Australians will feel that that's a competitive score. They can thank Steve Waugh for it. He really did play one of his finest Test hands today. I think Mark Taylor saw a couple of bare patches there, thought that they might help Shane Warne come fourth innings. Mm. And now, early on, he might have, you know, the old heart might have been going pitter-patter, yeah. But now I think he'll be quite satisfied.
Yeah, I feel from England's point of view, it's an opportunity lost to bowl Australia out for 160, 170. But now they've got a 220 with a wicket or two left. I think it's getting a bit dodgy because tomorrow that pitch I think will be fairly similar.
Well, we had to stop this British ruling the world bit, didn't we? We had Henmania, the Lions, and England won up in the Test series. Australia had to put their foot on it and stop all this.
Well, they just might have done, because I think tomorrow it's going to be still a difficult day for England batting. So all in all, I think we've got the same sort of contest, and Australia have got a good chance.
Thank you, Geoffrey.
Yes, lots of interest coming up on the second day of this match, which is also a sellout so far as the spectators are concerned. So too the Saturday and the Sunday. Wonderful attendance here, an absolute packed house, and we're looking forward to it on BBC tomorrow. That's where it'll be, BBC One, 10:50 a.m, the second day of this match at Old Trafford, the third Cornhill Test. We leave you now with two of the finest exponents of the arts of batting and bowling we've seen so far this summer. Steve Waugh with that magnificent innings, and Dean Headley making his debut in Test match cricket. For the moment, it's goodbye from Old Trafford.